Jonathan Paula presents Game Time.
Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome to episode 3 of the Grand Theft Auto 5 Let's Play on the PlayStation 3.
Hey, remember me as Mama.
What? I don't remember shit, honey. So, where we last left off, I jumped off a bridge into the LA River and broke my neck, wound up here at the hospital, and I thought we would continue our free roaming mayhem by, well, killing that guy, and then drive into the airport. So we could maybe steal a jumbo jet and have a little bit of fun, if you know what I mean. Yeah. But first, I want to turn down the background music so yous can hear me all right. Yeah. Some good music in this game, no doubt. But you want to be able to hear me talking too, right? Oh, Jesus. All right, so where are we going? I know it's down this way. Airport. I'm not going to lie. I did play a little bit between recordings, and I did already attempt to do this, and I failed. So, we're gonna try again to hijack a jumbo jet, because that's something they've never had before in Grand Theft Autos, and I'm really excited to try it. Oh, geez. Where's my special ability bar? I don't have any! Oops.
Oh, no!
Whatever I just had, I just used it up. So you regain your special ability bar, which is that yellow thing in the bottom left-hand corner. You have green, which is your health, blue, which is the armor, and yellow, which is your special ability bar. And you regain it by basically doing tricks and shit and overtaking vehicles. I don't know if that was good. I feel like generally smacking into things isn't. But this game rewards you in a lot of weird ways that you wouldn't normally suspect. Alright, this Pontiac fire shit is not cooperating with me the way I want it to. So this is very clearly Los Angeles International Airport. This is LAX, like, to a T. It is almost kind of eerie how close it resembles the airport I fly into so often. Alright, so we're gonna try to drive down this way, and there's a ramp right here. Let's hit it and see what happens. Oh boy!
Unbelievable, Hotshot. You hit that jump at just the right speed and angle. But will you be able to twerk your way out of this barrel roll? We shall find out soon enough. Howard Cosell here with your monster jump update. Here's the landing, and boom shakalaka, you failed. Sorry to say, but you already completed this jump. Until next time, Howard Cosell from ABC Sports. Thank you, Howard.
Alright, so here's the big problem. Got the special ability bar all the way maxed out with that jump, but now the po-po's is on my tail. Hey, go suck a dick. Suck my big black dick, you piece of shit. I can say that now because I'm playing an African-American character. Hey, what are you doing here? What is this? You're shooting me from helicopters? I don't like the fact that there's guys everywhere. I want... Alright, these planes weren't here a minute ago, were they? I want that big yellow guy. The big yellow guy. The one with, like, the big quad engines. I think he has four engines. Well, it should. If it doesn't, it should. No, it's cool. It's alright. I'm your friend. Don't mind me, Franklin, your neighborhood airline homie. Okay, I gotta back up. Turning, we're accelerating. Alright, we're still... Ah, geez. There's a lot of controls involved in piloting an aircraft of this size. You have your pitch, your yaw, all that stuff. L2, R2, the whole mess, right? So... Oh, geez, there's another plane on the runway! Get out of the way! I am cleared for takeoff, you fool! Oh, shit! I just lost a wing! I repeat, we have lost a wing! Oh, no! Oh, no, this is not good! Alright, I am reasonably certain this plane cannot fly with a severed wing. So I'm gonna get out, and I'm gonna run and grab the other airplane, because that... Well, you saw what I saw. That failed. That completely failed. Maybe I can steal the baggage truck and drive over there. See, I could grab one of these Learjets, which would be quicker to take off and way more maneuverable, but what fun would that be? It wouldn't be any fun, am I right? I want a big jet. Big jumbo jet. This guy right here, four engines right in front of me. This guy will do. And it looks like there's no obstacles in front of him. That's the tricky part. Oh, no, there's some, like, luggage carts and shit, so. Get up, Franklin! Get up, buddy! All right. He got bloodstains all over his nice new white t-shirt I picked up for him. All right, we're going to try this again. Full thrusters! Maximum reverse. Get out of the way, police car. I will run you off the runway. I've seen Mythbusters where they drove a Jeep behind a jet airliner, and it did not turn out well for the car. All right, full thrusters, dead ahead. Go around those luggage carts. Now we're taking a left. We're taking a left. This takes a lot of work, let me tell you what. Just pull up, pull up, pull up. That was a short runway, huh? All right, we are airborne. Excellent. So let's put up the landing gear. All right, landing gear is up. Flaps full. Eagle 20. Get out of the way, helicopter. I don't have time for your bullshit. There could be people on this airplane. You don't know. There wasn't at a jet trim. There's probably nobody on the plane. So this is only a minor, you know, terrorist event. Not like completely terrible. Oh, man, look how pretty the city looks. I'm sitting here tilting my head like a goober. All right, level out. I know what you're thinking. John, ram it into one of the buildings. Recreate 9/11. Come on. Come on now. Are you seriously think that I didn't already have that planned? No. Let's not for now. Maybe later. When we want to reenact our favorite Tuesday morning. Not really. This is terrible. That's a terrible line of jokes. I'm going to go straight to the atmosphere. Look at the contrails off this mother. Yeah. Look at this. Air heli. Cinematic camera. It gives you some nice view. Flying over Hollywood and Vinewood. This is a big map, right? I think that's Mount Chiliad over in the distance there, and that's like, seems like it's a ways away, and it's also on the other side of the map. Well, there's the Vinewood sign we committed suicide off of in the last video. That was exciting. Where else can we take this bad boy? West Vinewood. Can I do a barrel roll? Do a barrel roll! Slippy, shut up! After I get over Mulholland Drive, I'm going to try to execute a barrel roll a la drunken Denzel Washington in the movie Flight. Also going to try to get above the cloud level, so I have a little bit of altitude if my barrel roll completely fails. Oh, look how pretty that is. Huh? This game is great. I am so happy to be playing it. All right, well, cross your fingers and hope to die, because that's probably what's going to happen. Executing barrel roll! All right, let's complete the barrel roll. Wow, I was sure that the stresses of all of that would probably make the plane, you know, break apart, you know? I want to quickly pause here and take a look at the map. And you can see the area of exploration here is just, I'm just carving a line through the map. And there's a runway right next to me here. There's another runway there with those white lights. I guess they only appear when you're in a plane. So we've already flown quite a distance. Maybe half the map, I would say, because the map goes all the way up to this area. It's about half the map in only a couple minutes. So maybe it's not as big as I thought, but we are in a plane going a few hundred miles an hour. So, let me pull up and turn. Oh, geez. Pull up, pull up, pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Oh, I see now the mini-map in the corner actually has a level thing on it. Where was that runway? Where the frick was that runway? Well, looks like I'm lined up right for it. If I go slightly to my right... Oh, that must be it right in front of me, then. This... Oh, okay, I see it. Power down. This is gonna be rough. This is gonna be rough. We're gonna try to do it, though. There's the runway. Right in front. Gear deployed. Oh, jeez! Ah! I hit a telephone pole! What? What? I'm in a jumbo jet! That shit should have just leveled it like a lawnmower! Oh well, maybe I'll spawn in a new hospital because I flew so far. And by proxy, we automatically explored a new hospital. yeah, we are in Sandy Shores. We are out in the middle of nowhere. This is great. I'm in West Bumfuck, next to the county sheriff's office. This is... Super job, Franklin! Look what you did! Is that a dune buggy? A bird flying overhead. I want like a binocular view or something. Also, I did want that dune buggy. Excuse me, sir! Excuse me, sir! I'm lost! Can you help? Oh, he's a cop. Oh my. So... You come here often? Take this instead. Oh, Jesus! Hey, where's my police help now?
Oh, man.
Officer. No, I didn't want to do that. Okay, wait, real quick. I want to remember there was a game control where you can interact and speak. All right, I'm going to get out my book now. Use phone, jump. Talk to nearby ped. Okay. Hold right on the directional pad, and maybe I can communicate with this officer and file a report, because I just was in and hit a run with this bicycle. Hey, you!
Hey, what's cracking, officer? Good day.
Officer, what's cracking? Did you see what just happened?
Hey, you lame, dog.
Dumb fuck!
Okay, he put his hand on his gun. I'm gonna leave him alone. I'm gonna leave him alone. Where'd that guy on the bike go? I want retributions! Honky-ass crackers out here in the middle of nowhere. Black man ain't getting no respect! Alright, so what we got here? Autos, auto parts. That's clever.
Sometimes I drink until I can't feel my legs.
Fuck!
Hey, it's one of them... It's one of those half-pickup, half-car jobs. Yo, I'm taking your ATV, brother. No, I'm taking it. Get off. I'm taking it. See you later.
Bitch ass bullshit.
Woo! That was cool. Where are we right now? We're out in the middle of the desert. Wherever we are, it seems like a nice place. I bet people here aren't that racist. Oh, look out! Watch out, watch yourself. Watch out now. This is a backcountry. This is cool. See, this is the stuff I was missing from Grand Theft Auto 4. It's like, this, like... These little tiny suburb community explorations, you know? Some cool stuff out here. I said we were gonna go to a mission, and I did mean it. I feel like it's gonna take me a few minutes to get back there. That's alright, I got an ATV. I can go wherever the fuck I want! Woo, boy! Meant to do that. You all saw it. Where are we going now, Franklin? Oh, we got radio on this thing? Dope. Let's fire it up. What's this place? What's this place here? U-Tool! every little thing in this game makes me laugh. Gas station drive-by. I don't have any weapons yet, so I can't really do many drive-bys. Wow, even the highway has the rumble strip on the side of the road to prevent you from, you know, drifting off asleep. And the controller actually vibrates too. That's a nice subtle touch. I appreciate that. So I gotta go to my right here. So let's hang a right. Hey, it's the very large array. The VLA, they even have this in here? That's awesome. Let's check it out. I've always wanted to work for SETI. Seems like a cool place. You hang out and just listen to radios all day and see if you can't communicate with extraterrestrials. Franklin, walk around the side. Stop being a weirdo. The search for extraterrestrial intelligence. I remember back in the day, I actually used to own, or I own is a weird word to describe what it was, but I had a SETI screensaver, which actually used your computer's processing power to analyze all of the radio information that the VLA had obtained over the last, year or whatever. Because these guys point this giant fucking telescope, which is in real life, I think like 27 separate antennas, up to the heavens, and they just scan for radio waves and any sort of signals, audio, communication, hopefully from extraterrestrials or otherwise. And they just physically don't have the computing power to process it all and actually analyze all the data. So they actually allow users to go onto their site, download packets of data, and then basically analyze it on their computers. And then it sends, like, the results of that data encrypted back to SETI. But it actually functioned as a screensaver, so you could just sit there and watch your computer contribute to the search for extraterrestrial life while also kind of looking pretty on your screen. So that was pretty nice. And I really enjoyed that for sure. But after a while, I just wanted a better looking screensaver. So I stopped using that, but... it occurs to me now I was heading towards the purple dot, but the purple dot was the airport, not Franklin's next mission, so... I'm heading north right now. That is not the correct way to go. What's this, Indian reservation or something? Welcome to Senora National Park. Yeah, put on the helmet. That's after we've been bombing around for 20 minutes. Well, not a bad idea. What's this? Hey, what's up, Chief? You got anything here for me? Hey, what's this? Chihuahua hot dogs? Yeah, give me a hot dog. I took a spill earlier, I could use some health. What's up, bro?
So you like try real hard, don't you, homie?
Yo!
So what the do you not sell hot dogs at this Chihuahua place? You're a jerk. You're a jerk. Pop into the map. So this is where I've explored recently. So this is the little town I think I began from, right? Where did I get? I had to have begun from here, because this is the runway where I crashed, and then I appeared over here somewhere. Waypoint, movie house, strip club, movie. I don't see the option for what I guess you would call a hospital or a police station, because that it was over in this direction though, right? So we got to drive our Jesus Christ, what have I done? So that's where we got to go. So let's head there now. Sorry. Put on the helmet, Franklin. Just popped out of nowhere. The other one was still on the ground. Alright, so the game is not 100% realistic. I think we can live with it. Oh, look out! Watch yourself! This is fun. Oh, shit! Whoop. What was this? I saw another ATV? Yeah, just another one. It was a cooler color. Mine's just white. Man, this looks fun. I want to grab an ATV and just drive around the Southern California desert. Almost had an opportunity to do that when I was driving through the Salton Sea area earlier this March. But, did not have the time in the day. What? Come on! I barely got hurt. Fool. But... I didn't have the time of the day or really the money in the budget because it was like $50 for an hour. And I have been ATVing before, though, up in New Hampshire a long time ago when I was a kid, and it was quite a bit of fun. That seems like a hobby I could definitely get into. I think more so than like motorcycling or some other sort of motocross sport. I feel like ATVing would be more my speed and my style. I'm going to climb this billboard. Maybe there's like a hidden package or something. Oh, stamina. Franklin's getting more stamina. Oh, also, it occurred to me, I could probably switch to Michael, right? All right, don't fall off the edge like you did last time, you dummy. What's he say? Quality, margin. Oh, no, 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 no! I'm still alive!
Something don't feel too good.
Yeah, I don't feel too good either. Jesus, that would kill a normal man. Well, good job, Franklin. Oh, see, I can't switch to Michael yet. I haven't actually unlocked him. We saw him in the cinematic, but we haven't actually unlocked him proper, so I'm stuck with this boy for now. I still don't know what L3 does. It seems to just, like, hone my business. Let's climb this mountain. Wait, how'd I get my health back? I thought it was in the red. Does it just slowly regenerate? That's cool. Kind of taking a page from the Call of Duty playbook on that one. Although, to be fair, I don't believe Call of Duty was the first to pioneer that, but it's perhaps where I am most familiar with the auto-regenerating health. Something when I first played Call of Duty, I think, what, 7 or 8? Like, the second Modern Warfare, I think, was the first one I really played extensively. I remember thinking to myself, like, ooh, the health auto-regenerates. That's cool. I wish I had that in Perfect Dark. So, is there anything up here? I just climbed this big rock for nothing? Rockstar, you're supposed to reward my random exploration with little packages and things for me to grab. Why aren't you rewarding me? I can't climb this, can I? Oh, geez. He just ran straight down the side of a mountain. This guy is fucking Spider-Man. This is a mistake. Is there, like, a way to quick save and just teleport? Hey, look! Wolves! Come back! I need sustenance! Can I skin you alive and, like, gather your pelt and sell it at the trade shop, like in Red Dead Redemption? Alright, fine. Get out of here. Let's steal this guy's car. It's his fault for leaving it here next to this nice little turnout. Even the plates look Californian, right? Look at that. Alright, we're on the road again. On the road again. On the I'm off the road again. On the road again. On down the highway. I like to smoke some drugs. I am a real old hippie while I sing this song. On the road again. I'm off the road again, back on the over the road again, on top of the road again. I didn't need that fender, no way. Convertible mode engaged for maximum style points. Olay. Alright. Hey look, they even have the windmills off I-5, just like in real life. This is stupendous. Whatever I did fucked up the car. It does not drive very quick anymore. And it kind of pulls to one side. I'm not touching anything right now. It's just... Come on, where's, like, my boost ability? Why can't I hit, like, the nitros and just, like... If I can run this thing. Come on, let's do it! What am I doing here? Hell awaits. Wow, they even have the billboards down. That was something that really kind of intrigued and also annoyed me when I drove through the West on my cross-country road trip last month. And earlier this month, so many billboards that are just overtly invasive and political, like, abortion is terrible. And then, like, other ones that are like, abortion is awesome. And it's like, that's a very sensitive issue. You probably should leave it off billboards and, like, not butt into people's shit. And, like, I realize that, like, the Midwest is a lot more religious than, like, where I come from. But at the same time, like, there were some billboards, like, that just seems like you're invading my, you know, personal space and... This is a public road, and you're kind of infecting it with your political or religious doctrine. And, like, it doesn't really matter what religion it is or whether or not I support the message. I felt like just kind of offended that it was really kind of invasive the way they had these messages that were just really not having any business on a billboard, which I usually see as a commercial outlet for advertising like a shitty, you know, defense attorney or, you know, some injury claim dude. But this was different. I need to pick up a better car because this is a pile of junk. Or pick up some sort of flying machine. That would be helpful. What is this? Is this like a gas station pull-off? All right, good. Maybe somebody's filling up and I can steal their ride. Always make sure to break the passenger window so you don't have to sit in any glass. Come on, hotwire that thing. Alright, let's get back on the road. It's just like a real highway exit. You pay attention, like all the things are there. Alright, now we're traveling at speed. This is nice. Let's see if we can drive up this mountain. That's a no. That's a no. That's a big no. Or is it? There's a little mile count in the corner. 2.1 mile. What does that represent? Distance to target? It must represent that. 2.18 miles. Let's drive straight up this hill. All right, we made it. Well, there's the city. And that's the reservoir down there. I actually know where we are. This is like Lake Castaic. Huh. Dope. Some islands over there that probably don't exist in real life because there's not a lot of islands off the Southern California coast except for Catalina Island, which I have visited and made a video about it. You should go check it out. Oh, geez. Now, we can swim in this game. I know that for sure. Haven't done it yet, but I know that it is a thing. I'm not going to attempt it at the moment, but hopefully if we were to drive into the drink here, we'd be all... Actually, this might not be a mistake. This might be the Hoover Dam kind of analogy. I'm trying to think of a better word than analogy, but I feel like that really is like a pretty accurate phrase to describe what we're like the... The game is analogous to so many separate sections of the Southern California region. And just the Southwest region, really. So this isn't the Hoover Dam. This is not what the Hoover Dam looks like at all. But, this is a dam. I don't know if Castaic has a dam. Oh, well. We're still going here. We're still going. It's not a road. That's like a ditch. Oh, jeez. No, 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 no. Back up, back up, back up, back up, back up. I'm glad I got this car. This thing is impressive. Yeah, look at this thing off wheels. Nice. Nice. Drifting. Speaking of Tokyo drifting, did y'all hear that Lucas Black has been signed on for the next 3 Fast and Furious movies? I don't know how I feel about that. Like, Tokyo Drift is easily the worst in the entire franchise. Actually, you know what? 2 is pretty terrible. Too Fast, Too Furious is not a very good film. But, like, the one thing I didn't like about Tokyo Drift was that stupid southern redneck they had in the lead role, Lucas Black. And he was likable enough. And, you know, in the movie, he's like a fast-talking racer man with a heart of gold. But they're going to bring him back into the franchise, which is an interesting move considering you would have thought, given its disappointing performance and lack of all other cast members, that they would have basically just, like, you know, cleaned themselves of any association with Tokyo Drift. But at the end of 6, not to spoil much, they basically doubled down. It's like, no, Tokyo Drift was part of this franchise, and we're going to make sure that we reincorporate it more and strongly into the story. So, kind of looking forward to seeing how they bring Lucas Black back into the Fast and the Furious fold for the next come. And 3 movies? That means they're going to go all the way to 9? That's awesome. I love the Fast and Furious series. I loved it before it was fashionable, you know? Done movie night reviews on a couple of them so far. And again, you can check out those videos if you feel so inclined. I really wanted to do a mission in this video, but I feel like we're probably going to run out of time before we get there. But if that happens, hopefully you enjoyed what we've done so far.
Because unfortunately for now, that will have to do it for this episode of Game Time, but stay tuned for the next installment of the Grand Theft Auto 5 Let's Play, where we return to the story missions and take out a group of gangbangers who stole a motorcycle. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.